And welcome everyone to Kalisburg High School for volleyball action tonight from Class 3A. UIL, the Kalisburg Lady Cats, who are ranked number 4 in the state and come into tonight's match with a record of 36-4, taking on their district rivals from Gunner, the Gunner Lady Tigers, who are vying for a playoff berth tonight. Expecting a good match, it is a very special night here in Kalisburg. It is Play for Papa night, as they do their own cancer awareness night, as so many schools around the nation do during October. But they're playing for in memory of a former coach here at Kalisburg, Mike Wallace, who passed away just a couple of years ago. So not only are they honoring him tonight, they're raising some money for a scholarship in his name. They've been having a raffle that people have been signing up for, a silent auction, a bake sale going on. I know I bought a couple of cookies from the bake sale. I'm looking forward to eating those after the match. But all that money will go to scholarships to honor the memory of Coach Mike Wallace. So Play for Papa night here in Kalisburg tonight. They're doing some of the raffle drawings right now, drawing out names. I'm really hoping they don't draw out my name for one of the things. They're having an honorary first serve. They're doing it right now to make sure they're not going to call my name. I don't want to go out and embarrass myself on the court. All right, good. It wasn't me. Banner Tidwell gets to do the honorary first serve tonight to get us started. And she's a little embarrassed about coming down, but she's going to come out. We're going to cover this for you here. Let's get the honorary first serve, if we can see some of that from Banner when she gets out on the court. And it's a good first serve, right to the libero, Chase Falger. So congratulations to Banner, and again, a great cause tonight as they are raising money for the scholarships that honor former Kalisburg coach Mike Wallace, who lost his battle with cancer just in the last couple of years. It's Play for Papa night here at Kalisburg High School. The Lady Cats and Lady Tigers, Kalisburg and Gunner, coming up here in just a little bit. We'll take a quick break, be back with the first serve. You're watching high school volleyball on ccsportstalk.com.
Shop in your own backyard. A bundle from Nortex Communications is your local choice for internet, TV, and phone. We offer internet faster than ever with consistent, affordable speeds. TV delivers more HD choices, convenient DVR and TiVo options, and now free TV everywhere. Your unlimited home phone keeps you in touch for less. We also offer IT support and business solutions. For more information, call 940-759-2251 or visit nortex.com.
With a First State Bank debit card, you'll have the freedom to enjoy every.
County Sports Talk.
Darren, Clay, and Jerry, your three sports amigos on Cook County Sports Talk from Hometown Radio, KGAF.
Cook County Sports Talk, KGAF.
When your car needs repair, remember ABC. Auto Body Concepts, your complete collision repair facility. At Auto Body Concepts, we take care of you, and we back it up with a lifetime warranty, updating you every step of the way. That's outstanding customer service. Auto Body Concepts, with two big locations in Gainesville, just off Highway 82, and the new location in Ardmore on North Rockford Road. Remember ABC. Auto Body Concepts, complete collision repair.
The things that bring us together, as families, as friends, as a community, the things that we see, the things that we hear, and the things that we do. The employees of the Cook County Electric Cooperative are proud to be a part of what brings us together. From a cup of coffee to Friday night lights, thank you for letting us be part of your life. Cook County Electrical Cooperative, we'll keep the light on for you.
At Kelly Wimmer Dentistry in Gainesville, we specialize in making beautiful smiles. Dr. Wimmer offers family dentistry for all ages, general dentistry, cosmetic dentistry, restorative care, gum care, and more. Dr. Wimmer strives to help each patient achieve optimal dental care, offering state-of-the-art techniques and equipment. Call for your appointment today, 940-612-4444. That's 940-612-4444. Kelly Wimmer Family and Cosmetic Dentistry, 2022 West Highway 82 in Gainesville, or at wimmerdds.com.
This is my community.
This is my history.
This is my future.
This is my health.
This is my choice.
This is my hospital.
This is my hospital.
This is my hospital.
This is our hospital.
If you're looking for a seriously simple mortgage, look no further than First State Bank. Our lending specialists take great pride in helping homebuyers get the best mortgage. We give you options that suit your needs and keep the lending process as simple as possible. Build your relationship with a First State Bank lender now by calling 940-665-1711 or applying online at f-s-b.com.
Hometown Radio 1580.
Good morning, North Texas.
Dee Blanton wakes you up with hometown local news.
On the midday, playing your all-time favorites back-to-back.
Steve Eberhardt, middays 9:30 till 2. The Leopards, Knights, Hornets, Tigers, Eagles, and Wildcats. We cover them all here on Hometown Radio 1580.
There we go. We've had the introductions of both teams. We've had the national anthem, and now we're ready for the first serve. Kalisberg and Gunner coming up for you live tonight on ccsportstalk.com. As again, Kalisberg looking to keep a streak alive. I believe they have now won 35 consecutive district matches. Matter of fact, the last time they lost, the senior class were just freshmen, and it was the first game of that district season. I'm joined now courtside by Ronnie Conyers, who is on the faculty here at Kalisberg High School and also the voice of the Wildcats and Lady Cats on Camp Sweeney's KPFC. And you've gotten to watch a lot of good volleyball over the last 4 years since they lost that last district game, that's for sure.
Absolutely. It's been one of the most exciting sports we've had going here at Kalisberg. These Lady Cats they've been special ever since the beginning. And they've just gotten better and better as the years have gone by. And now, you know, ranked, I think, number 4 in the state at this point. So, yeah, we've seen some great volleyball. And it's just hard to beat a good volleyball match.
It is. You've called a lot of them. You've followed them all the way to state. And it was so heartbreaking to see what happened last year when they make it to the state championship game. Then pretty much the entire team gets food poisoning. And even though they played their hearts out on that final day, just didn't have the energy, and they came up short.
Yeah, that's right. They just weren't at their best. They did play. They played a tremendous match considering the opponent they had in Goliad and considering half of them, like you say, were not feeling well that day. But they went out and gave a valiant effort. And, you know, it's hard to get to that level. So they're just working real hard. They dedicated themselves this year to getting back to that tournament and to have another shot at maybe that state championship.
Yeah, this is a team that relies heavily on seniors, so this is the year for them to do it. Yeah. They've got a lot of seniors out there. We'll see them throughout the match. Matter of fact, looking at the starters out there, so I guess five of the six out there are seniors right now. The only one, Emma Sledge, the sophomore. Right. The other five are seniors. So looking forward to that. Gunner gets the first serve, and it'll be Kinsey Hamilton to get us started. Here from Kalisburg High School tonight on Play for Papa night. And the first attack by Skylar Allen, and she's in the net, so Gunner's going to get the first point of the match.
Yeah, it was a great hit. She just got a little too close to the net and grazed it. It wasn't a obvious mistake, but if you're an official standing right there, you see it.
So 1-0, the Lady Tigers with the lead as Hamilton serves again. And Kalisburg not able to return that off the hands of Sledge. Jill Enderby stuck a hand out there as well, but a quick 2-0 lead for Gunner.
Sledge is not the one you want to take the first hit and then make that first pass. That her strength is at the net.
Yeah, that's why she's standing at the net, and that's why they served in that direction, I guess. There's a service error on Gunner, so now Kalisburg going to get to serve. Down 2-1, it'll be Chase Falgu. A chance here for Gunner. Nice dig on the back row by Macy Satterwhite. Attack of the net, another dig by Satterwhite. Buller going to set up Allen this time, goes over the block. Little tip by Gunner, but it's saved. Satterwhite gets it over. Good rally there by Kalisburg. Tip of the net by Gunner, and they get a point. That is number 4, Lakin Satre, who comes up with a nice tip over the net. Good rally that time by both teams.
Yeah, absolutely. The Lady Cats played it well. They just allowed Gunner to get the advantage on that return hit.
And there's a good break for Gunner. That serve hits the top ribbon of the net and just crawls over for an ace.
Yeah, Gunner's no team to take lightly. They're going to come out and play hard.
Yeah, saw them earlier when they played Lindsay. Played the Lady Knights tough, and they've just gotten better since then. Yeah. There's another strong hit on the left side. I believe that is Shea Pruitt with the swing. Gets the point for the Lady Tigers, and watch out, they're up 5-1.
Yeah, Gunner has their best rotation out there right now.
Another short serve. This one doesn't clear the net.
Lady Cats are, it's not unusual for them to come out kind of a slow start. Our district is not the strongest, and so they've at times relaxed a little bit and maybe haven't come out as intensely as they should have.
Lindsay Bullard with the serve for Kalisburg, and Gunner ends up hitting the ball out. So an attack error on the Lady Tigers gives Kalisburg a point and pulls them within two. Try to show you the serve from down low and then go up top for the overhead view. As our overhead camera is in a position where you can't see the service line back here because of the angle. There's a service error on Kalisburg and a point for Gunner.
Yeah, it's really unusual for Bullard to hit one out like that.
I think she has lived and breathed volleyball since she was born, with her mom being the coach at the college.
She comes by naturally, that's for sure.
Here's a chance for Gunner,
nice
blocked in the net.
Yeah.
Savannah Hott and the homecoming queen herself, Fallon Bauckham, going up to block that one.
Yeah, it's good to see Hott back in the lineup. She played her first game back from injury on Friday, so it's really good to see her out there in that rotation. She makes a big difference.
Yeah, definitely wanted to get her healed and ready to go in time for the playoffs. There's a service error again on Kalisburg. So the two people you probably would not expect to hit the ball into the net, Lindsay Bullard and Skylar Allen. 7-4, Gunner leads. Number 12, J.C. Childers, to serve, and she returns the favor.
Well, all of our teams tonight have had trouble serving for some reason, both JV teams as well as here the varsities in the early parts of this match.
Here is the serve by Bauckham. And it'll tip over that. Gunner's going to get the point there. 8-5, Lady Tigers lead. Number 5, Beth Gilbert to serve. A chance here for Hott, but they're going to call a double hit on the set by Bullard.
Yeah. Not a good set in the first place. They just got that little extra action on the set, called for a double.
So back to a 4-point lead for Gunner. Here's Macy Satterwhite down the line, dug by the Lady Tigers. A chance here, and she puts it down. That is Lakin Satre again, who gets the point for Gunner, and that's going to cause Angela Allen to call a timeout. We'll take it with them. Timeout on the court. Kalispell trailing 10-5. You're watching high school volleyball on ccsportstalk.com.
Shop in your own backyard. A bundle from Nortex Communications is your local choice for internet, TV, and phone. We offer internet faster than ever with consistent, affordable speeds. TV delivers more HD choices, convenient DVR and TiVo options, and now free TV everywhere. Your unlimited home phone keeps you in touch for less. We also offer IT support and business solutions. For more information, call 940-759-2251 or visit nortex.com.
With a First State Bank debit card, you'll have the freedom to enjoy every purchase. Student accounts from First State Bank. Sign up for yours today.
Cook County Sports Talk.
Darren, Clay, and Jerry, your three sports amigos on Cook County Sports Talk. From hometown radio, KGAF.
Cook County Sports Talk, KGAF.
Back. There we go. Back to action. 11-5. Gunner with another point out of the timeout. And they are surprising the number four ranked Lady Cats here in the first set. Satterwhite, the little tip, finds the open spot there on the sideline. And there's a much needed side out for Kalispell.
Yeah, that previous serve before we came back, Allen just misplayed the serve and couldn't get a pass up to the front.
Here is Hot to serve, and she gets the benefit of the top ribbon of the net. It crawls over, and then there's Lindsay Bullard to put it down. Sometimes better to be lucky and good, and that's been good. And Savannah Hot was. She hit, again, the top ribbon of the net, and it crawls over. This time, a much better serve. Oh. It's Macy Satterwhite with the kill.
Happy birthday. They stated it perfectly for Macy.
When that first pass goes over the net, those girls at the net, those hitters get those big wide eyes as they see the ball coming over, and Macy able to put it down. 11-8 now. Kalispell back within three. Here's an attack down the line by Olivia Eft. Saved by Kalispell. Another chance, though, coming up here for the Lady Tigers. Little tip dug up nicely by Bullard. Here's Satterwhite, and she puts it down. Get a look at that here on the instant replay as we again see Skylar Allen going to get credit with the assist this time as Macy Satterwhite goes out and puts it down just in front of the dive there.
Yeah, that's a great placement on that one.
Back to live action now, 11-9. Bullard sets up Satterwhite. She's going to have to tip this one over. Tip of the net again is Sledge and Bullard went up, kept it alive. Here's Satterwhite off the block, tipped at the net. Somebody's in the net, and it's going to be Gunner.
Well, I'm sure Coach Allen in that timeout shared some encouraging words with the ladies, and it's starting to show up in the way they're playing.
Yeah, a good rally here for Kalispell. They're back within one at 11-10. Another good save in the back row, this time by Skylar Allen. Macy Satterwhite dug by Pruitt. Allen going to set up Satterwhite down the line, and she got it off the dig attempt. And just like that, we're tied.
Well, that's one of the advantages. You've got so many girls for Kalispell that are good at setting the ball when they need to.
Yeah, you don't have to rely on just one. Yep. There's a service error on Hot as she hit that one into the net. So side out. Gunner needed that. They're back up 12-11. And it will be the libero, Nia Ingram, to serve for the Lady Tigers. And these two teams have been in the same district many, many years and always seem to battle. There's Satterwhite again with the kill for Kalispell.
That's one of the things that Lindsay Bullard is best at, knowing where her players are and where the opponents are playing. And she sets it to the right person at the right time. And I just got that Macy Satterwhite on the backside, so great play.
So it will be Satterwhite to serve with this all tied up 12 apiece. There's a chance for Gunner. Nice dive by Satterwhite. A little quick set over the net. Lindsay Bullard.
Got that one up somehow.
Emma Sledge puts it down. There's your middle blocker right there in the middle of the net. Puts it down. Want to say hello to her family watching out in East Texas tonight.
Well, Sledge is a sophomore, but, man, she's coming along. She's going to be a powerhouse before she's done.
Yeah, nice to have a 5'11 or 6'4 girl at the net. There's another service error, though, on Kalisberg.
Yeah, a girl like that enrolls in school, and all the coaches are just drooling, hoping that she plays their sport.
Yeah, absolutely. Coach Payne probably wanting to know if she can get a basketball in her hand, too, here in a few weeks.
He's already had that discussion with her.
Tied at 13, Gunner with the serve. Here's Skylar Allen. Nice tip of the net, but it goes out, so a point for Kalisberg.
It's a good attempt at a block there by Gunner, but that was coming from so high that they couldn't get the block down, and it just bounced off and went out of bounds.
It's amazing. Skylar, not the tallest girl out there, but, man, can she jump.
She can get up.
Chase Falgu with the serve here for the Lady Cats. Gunner going to hit this one out. So a point for Kalisberg, and maybe they have weathered the storm here early on after being down by, I think it was as much as five. They're now up by two. Another serve for Falgu. And another point for Kalisberg.
Well, Gunner will probably finish third in district, it looks like. You know, so they're a very good team. They've been coached well for years and years, and so they're not going to make a whole lot of mistakes.
Another timeout, this one called by Gunner. We'll take it as well. 16-13, Kalisberg leads. You're watching High School Volleyball, ccsportstalk.com.
When your car needs repair, remember ABC. Auto Body Concepts, your complete collision repair facility. At Auto Body Concepts, we take care of you, and we back it up with a lifetime warranty, updating you every step of the way. That's outstanding customer service. Auto Body Concepts, with two big locations in Gainesville, just off Highway 82, and the new location in Ardmore on North Rockford Road. Remember, ABC, Auto Body Concepts, complete collision repair.
Back in Kalisberg, again, Kalisberg playing in the old gym. The new gym is still not ready to go after the pipe bust back in August, I guess it was, maybe even July.
Yeah, right before school started, about a week before school started. It's looking better. They're putting the hardwood down.
I was talking to Coach Gary Jack, the athletic director, saying getting closer and closer, but they're still a few weeks away probably. 16-13 here.
Going real slow. That was a nice hit by Gunner. I didn't see who put it down.
That's going to be number four, Lakin Satre again, who got it just in front of the end line back here. So a point for Gunner. They're back within two after the side out, 16-14, and it will be Satre to serve. Falgu, Bullard, Fallon Bauckham hit it a little bit too strong.
Yep.
Nice play run that time. That little back set to Bauckham, but she got underneath it a little bit, hit it out. So a point for Gunner.
That's typically a good play, a little bit of misdirection on it.
Here's Skylar Allen. She doesn't miss too often. Good block of the net, though, by Gunner. Swing by Shea Pruitt, dug by Falgu. This time, Allen able to put it down. 17-15. Jill Enderby checks out. Savannah Hott checks back in. Lindsay Bullard goes back to serve. With her team leading by two. There's a ball at the net and not able to get it. Gunner, number five, Beth Gilbert went up for it, but she was in the net anyway, but landed on their side. So a point for Kalisberg, 18-15. Now just 7 points away from taking the first set. Gunner coach Caitlin Gill wants to get an explanation from the cheer umpire. Caitlin was quite the athlete at Whitesboro High School back in the day. Caitlin Labhart is what a lot of people remember her as.
Right, yeah, absolutely.
She played every sport there and was a stud in all of them. So after the explanation, Kalisberg served. Lindsay Bullard.
Ooh,
nice swing there by Gilbert, but it's dug by Kalisberg. Skylar Allen hits a little bit too strong.
Yep.
18-16 after the side out. Gunner to serve. We'll have a substitution before that. As Shea Pruitt goes out. And I believe that is Audrey Curtis, number 9, that will check in, and she will serve. Satterwhite, Bullard, Allen, cross court, Doug. That was Curtis with the dig. And now they're going to call a double hit.
Yep.
So another unforced error. And it's a point for Gunner, and they're back within one at 18-17. Bowler going to set up Allen this time. What a block by Gunner. They're all over those hits from Allen. Now a double hit going to be called on Gunner. Okay.
Well, what Gunner tried to do in the previous matchup was try to take Skylar Allen out of the match, and that's what they seem to be doing tonight, keying on her. So if Hot and Satterwhite can get hot, then the Lady Cats can compensate for that.
2-point lead here for Kalisberg with the serve. Little tip dug there by Bullard. Allen going to set up Satterwhite, goes cross court.
Yeah.
And that'll work. 20-17, nice job by Satterwhite to see the two double blockers in front of her and go around them cross court for the point. Another good serve by Allen with the jump serve. There's a swing of the net blocked by Bockham, and it's Gunner in the net.
Well, one thing about the Lady Cats is they're not only talented athletically, but they're gifted students as well. They're smart on the court. They don't make a lot of mental errors.
It's been a key to their success over the past 3 years for sure. There's a block attempt at the net by Hott and Bockham, but a good swing that time. I believe that's number five, Beth Gilbert, that gets credit with the kill. J.C. Childress to serve for the Lady Tigers, who trail by three. We're in the opening set, this best three out of five. Bowler going to set up Allen behind the 10-foot line. Good save by Gunner. Little tip over the net by Bullard, and they're going to call the setter losing. She leave her feet to hit that one? Is that what they're calling?
Must have. That's the only thing I could see that happened, because she wasn't up over the net.
Whatever the call, it goes against Kalisberg and gives Gunner another point. Makes it 21-19 as Childress serves again, but she serves it out. So a free point for Kalisberg. They're three away from taking the first set, and Fallon Bockham goes back here to serve. Good serve by Bockham. Free ball here, so a chance for Kalisberg. Bullard going to set up Satterwhite to put it down.
That's hard to defend when you have Sledge and Satterwhite both going up. You don't know who they're going to set it to. That time is Satterwhite. She just put a beautiful one down.
Timeout called by Gunner, 23-19. We'll take it with them. CCSportsTalk.com. It's high school volleyball action.
The things that bring us together as families, as friends, as a community, the things that we see, the things that we hear, and the things that we do. The employees of the Cook County Electric Cooperative are proud to be a part of what brings us together. From a cup of coffee to Friday night lights, thank you for letting us be part of your life. Cook County Electrical Cooperative. We'll keep the light on for you.
So after the timeout, Fallon Bockham to serve again. Her team just 2 points away from taking the first set. They lead 23-19. Another good serve by Bockham. It's a big swing that time by Gunner, but they're blocked to the net again. Savannah Hott. And just like that, it's set point. Bockham will try to get us to the second set early here. Little scramble at the net. Blocked up there by Sledge, but it lands on the Kalisberg side. Good swing again that time by Beth Gilbreth for Gunner. Gives her team a point, makes it 24-20. And she will go back to serve. Kalisberg just needs one more point here to win the first set. Macy Satterwhite, nice dig on the back row by Gunner. Another chance, though, for Satterwhite. Is she set up by Bullard?
Yep.
It's blocked to the net, but it lands on the Gunner side, and Kalisberg does take the first set, 25-20. So a good first set for Kalispell. They started a little slow, fell behind. I should say a great start for Gunner to jump ahead by 5 points at one point. Kalispell battles back, though, to win 25-20.
It's good for the Lady Cats to be tested here because there's one more district game. They do have a warm-up game this Friday against Glenrose. That'll be a big test.
That's going to be a test.
Yeah. But they need this bit of a challenge here going into the playoffs.
So 25-20, Kalispell takes the first set. We'll be back with the first serve of the second set next. You're watching High School Volleyball on ccsportstalk.com.
At Kelly Wimmer Dentistry in Gainesville, we specialize in making beautiful smiles. Dr. Wimmer offers family dentistry for all ages. General dentistry, cosmetic dentistry, restorative care, gum care, and more. Dr. Wimmer strives to help each patient achieve optimal dental care, offering state-of-the-art techniques and equipment. Call for your appointment today. 940-612-4444. That's 940-612-4444. Kelly Wimmer Family and Cosmetic Dentistry. 2022 West Highway 82 in Gainesville or at WimmerDDS.com.
This is my community.
This is my history.
This is my future.
This is my health.
This is my choice.
This is my hospital.
This is my hospital.
This is my hospital.
This is our hospital.
If you're looking for a seriously simple mortgage, look no further than First State Bank. Our lending specialists take great pride in helping homebuyers get the best mortgage. We give you options that suit your needs and keep the lending process as simple as possible. Build your relationship with a First State Bank lender now by calling 940-665-1711 or applying online at f-s-b.com.
Hometown Radio 1580.
Good morning, North Texas.
Dee Blanton wakes you up with hometown local news.
On the midday, playing your all-time favorites back-to-back.
Steve Eberhardt, middays 9:30 till 2. The Leopards, Knights, Hornets, Tigers, Eagles, and Wildcats. We cover them all here on Hometown Radio 1580.
Back at Kalispell High School, the Lady Cats win the first set 25-20. And like we said, Ronnie, it wasn't a pretty start, but a good team find ways to win.
Absolutely. You're going to have bad starts every now and then. You're going to make some mistakes. But the champions will overcome their own mistakes. Now, obviously, you don't want to make them in the first place. But when you do, you got to find a way to overcome it and get back in the game.
And a lot of the credit for that has to go to Gunner. They came out and played really, really well all the way through. So some service errors kind of cost them for sure. But 25-20, I think they'll be proud of their effort in the first set, and they'll come out here as the two teams switch sides. We get ready for set number two. Again, Kalispell 36-4 on the year. They already have a win over the number one team in the state, Boyd. I was looking at the rankings. You got Goliad second, Denver City third, Kalispell fourth. And the funny thing is all those teams are in different regions. That could be, I mean, we're way far away from the state tournament. Yeah. There could be your state tournament.
That certainly could be. That night at, of course, at NCTC when the Lady Cats played Boyd, that could have been a preview. You know, they struggled a little bit, but again, number one team in the state. So the Lady Cats have proven themselves over and over again.
There was an ace by Macy Satterwhite there, so Kalispell with a 1-0 lead. Satterwhite serves again. Good swing there by Pruitt for Gunner. There's Skylar Allen. Somebody's in the net. They say Gunner was.
Gunner was in the net. Okay.
Close call there. It goes against Gunner. So another point for Kalispell. They lead 2-0. And Satterwhite, the senior, will serve again. Another good serve. So Gunner going to have to scramble around. They're not able to get an attack. Bullard to Sledge, they're going to call a little
double
hit, yeah. Four players for Kalispell, for these seniors, have already committed to college. Two to play beach volleyball. Skylar Allen to South Carolina, Macy Satterwhite to A&M Kingsville. Then, of course, Lindsey Bullard and Savannah Hott are going to play indoor volleyball at NCTC. So You know you got a pretty good team when you got four players that are going to be playing in college
Absolutely.
Next year. There's a swing by Lake and Satre. It goes off the block and out, so a good point for Gunner to tie the match or tie the setup at two apiece. Serve here by Kinsey Hamilton. Here's Skylar Allen, goes cross court around the block, but a good dig there by Satre. Buller with a quick set, yeah. And there was nobody there. Man, she put it in the perfect spot.
Well, the fact that Allen and Satterwhite are going to play beach volleyball, that tells you what all-around players they are. They're capable of doing all of it, because in beach volleyball, you got to set, you got to kill, you got to do it all.
I think they were teammates in beach volleyball, too,
they
in
were.
Some
yes.
tournaments.
Yes, so they were.
Got to play out in California, Florida, yeah. A lot of places.
Yeah, played down in Gulf Shores, Alabama.
There's a big swing by Beth Gilbert, and she puts it down. Another kill for Gilbert, gives Gunner another point, and ties this set up at three apiece. And serving will be Satre, who's recorded quite a few kills of her own tonight. A little tip by Bullard, and again it finds the floor. She just has a knack of knowing where to put the ball. You know, sometimes that pass, it's not in the perfect spot for her to set somebody up, so she kind of just bails herself out by tipping it over, yeah. And it seems to find the floor quite
yeah,
a bit.
Yeah, she's got great instincts.
Bullard serving here.
Ooh, nice dig.
Yeah, that was a foul go with the serve off the big hit by Gilbreth, and then Allen with the kill. 5-3, Kalisberg with a two-point lead after winning the first set 25-20.
Yeah, you love to see the big hitters, but boy, that back line is so important.
Falgo, another one of those seniors, right?
Yep, she is.
There's a lucky break there from the back row. Satre way behind the 10-foot line, almost back here at the end line. She hit it over, it hit the top of the net, crawled over the net, so a point for Gunner.
Yeah, it's hard to get those. Yes.
You go up and thinking it's going to go one place, and it lands right in front of you.
You got to be lucky if you're going to get one of those back.
Audrey Curtis to serve for the Lady Tigers. Little tip over the net by Savannah Hott. Good job that time by Hott.
Well, Gunner vacated the left front corner of the floor, and Hott saw it and just put it there.
6-4, Kalisberg lead back to 2. Skylar Allen goes back to serve. They set up their big hitter again, does Gunner, but she hits it out. Gilbreth tried to go around the block to the right side that time. She hit it wide right. So 7-4, Kalisberg's lead now up to 3. Another jump serve here by Allen.
Oh, nice.
Nice save by Kalisberg. Another nice save. Scrambling around trying to keep the ball off the floor. Another tip by Gunner. Here's Macy Satterwhite down the line and in. Nobody was back in the far corner. Or as you're watching it, I guess on TV, it would be the near corner. 8-4. Kalisberg stretching things out here in the second set, already leading one set to nothing. Buller going to set up hot that time, and she just tips it over, and it finds the floor again.
Yeah, that's one of those cases, again, you said better to be lucky than good sometimes. It just happened to fall Kalisberg's way.
Timeout called on the court, this time by Gunner. They trail 9-4. We'll take it with them. Back with more high school volleyball, ccsportstalk.com in just a moment.
Shop in your own backyard. A bundle from Nortex Communications is your local choice for internet, TV, and phone. We offer internet faster than ever with consistent, affordable speeds. TV delivers more HD choices, convenient DVR and TiVo options, and now free TV everywhere. Your unlimited home phone keeps you in touch for less. We also offer IT support and business solutions. For more information, call 940-759-2251 or visit nortex.com.
We thank all of our sponsors, Nortex Communications, Auto Body Concepts, Kelly Wimmer DDS, Cook County Electric Co-op, the First State Bank, and North Texas Medical Center, along with Hometown Radio KGAF, now in FM stereo at 92.3. Bringing you high school volleyball action on a Tuesday night from Kalisberg High School, the number 4-ranked Lady Cats taking on Gunner. after the timeout. Skylar Allen with another good serve and another big hit. There's Beth Gilbert again. If you're Gunner, you just got to keep setting her.
This Gunner team's going to be really good next year, I think.
Number 12, J.C. Childers to serve for the Lady Tigers. Thought about it. Stop. Resets. Here we go.
I think she missed it on the bounce.
There's a swing by Bach on block at the net. They go right back to Gilbert, and she comes through again.
Nice placement right through the hands, or between the hands of Hott and Bachum on the block.
9-6. Gunner with a couple of points in a row here to pull within three. Bullard with a little bump set to Satterwhite, blocked at the net there. I believe that was Olivia F. that got up and got it. Now she tries to swing. It's blocked by Bachum and Satterwhite. It's another chance here for Kalisberg.
There.
And there's Satterwhite, puts it down. Man, so hard to see her. We saw this in the first set, too. They kind of shield her with somebody in front of her. They back set to her, and she's able to put it down. A lot of plays, a lot of play calls go into volleyball that you don't always see from the stands.
Yeah, more of the volleyball than most people think.
Yeah. They know exactly where they're going with it on pretty much every time. There's a hit into the net, so another free point for Kalisberg. 11-6 now, as it is Bachum, another senior back there serving for the Lady Cats. Set here by Childress. Nice block of the net that time. Buller going to set up Hott. Blocked by Gilbert, but it goes out, so a point for Kalisberg.
Savannah Hott getting a little more rhythm after being off for several weeks. She came back just in time to get that rhythm back before start the playoffs.
Yeah, good timing to get her three or four matches in here before you got to start that playoff run. There's a swing by Gilbert, but it goes into the net, so four hits called there. Another point for Kalisberg, 13-6. The lead is ballooned to 7. They won the first set 25-20. There's a swing that time by Harley Ward. Another chance here for Gunner. They go back to Gilbert. Off the block and out, so a point for Gunner. And correct me if I'm wrong, Kalisberg has only lost one set in district.
I believe at
Ponder, maybe?
They lost the first set to Ponder a couple of weeks ago. Started off slow, and Ponder capitalized on it. But they came back and dominated before the match was over.
There's another point for Gunner. Good job at the net with the block. That is number 8, Olivia Eft again. So 13-8, Gunner with a little rally here. It's Beth Gilbert with another good serve. Lindsay Buller going to have to scramble to set this one up. She does to Macy Satterwhite. Nice dig on the back row by Gunner. Here's Savannah Hott. Hits the top of the net and goes over. Another quick set there by Bullard, but Gunner able to track it down, and now a double hit going to be called.
Well, one of Bullard's strengths is that she can take a bad pass and turn it into a good set and give her hitters a chance to get a point down.
Yeah, even on the run like that one was. She had to go all the way from the middle of the court over by the official stand. Timeout for a shoe repair. Shoestring needed to be tied by Bullard. Now we're ready to go with the serve from Hott. Right in the middle, that's Harley Ward with the kill attempt. But there's a kill for Macy Satterwhite. Adds to her total, makes it 15-8. Glad to have so many people watching tonight. Let us know where you're watching from on Twitter. Let us know at KGAF Sports Talk. There's a swing and it's out. So another point for Kalisberg, another timeout for Gunner. Coach Caitlin Gill wants to talk it over. We'll step aside as well. 16-8, Kalisberg with the lead. You're watching High School Volleyball, ccsportstalk.com.
With a First State Bank debit card, you'll have the freedom to enjoy every purchase. Student accounts from First State Bank. Sign up for yours today.
Cook County Sports Talk.
Darren, Clay, and Jerry, your three sports amigos on Cook County Sports Talk from Hometown Radio, KGAF.
Cook County Sports Talk, KGAF.
Except for SNS and Pottsboro.
We're back to action after the timeout here in Kalispell. The Lady Cats with a 2-set-to-none lead. And they have the serve, leading 16-8 in the second set. Just discussing the district race. Kalispell, of course, in first place. Ponder looks like they'll probably get second. This Gunner team could get third. And what do you think? Maybe Pilot Point battling for that fourth spot.
Pilot Point or Whitesboro looks like maybe a toss-up. I haven't looked at it the last couple of days, but both those teams seem to be fighting for that fourth spot.
There's a point for Gunner to give them a side out after a pretty good run by Kalispell. Put them up by 8. Now they're up by 7 at 16-9 as Nia Ingram serves. Bullard with a set to Satterwhite right down the line and in. See if we had time to get a replay of that one. We may get the tail end of it here. There you go. Here's a quick set by Bullard. Satterwhite right down the line. Nobody could block that.
That was beautiful.
So 17-9 as Satterwhite serves. Another chance here for the Lady Cats. Bullard this time goes over to Allen. Blocked there by Eft. Not one of the tallest players, but she was able to get up and get the block, keep the point alive here for her team. But it's hit into the net by Gunner, so point Kalispell. Right now the Lady Cats doubling up the Lady Tigers here in the second set, already leading 1-0. Another good serve by Satterwhite. And a dig by Satterwhite. Bullard sets up Allen.
Ooh.
Dug on the back row by Gilbert. Scramble here. Olivia Eft gets it over, and he'll work it out to be a point. You don't have to be looking in the right direction to hit the ball over the net. That one hit off the fingertips of Fallon Bauckham, and then landed in.
That's a play the Lady Cats would like to have back.
18-10. As Kenzie Hamilton to serve again for Gunner. Little tip over the net by Allen. Lakin Sautre returns the favor, and this one lands on the Kalispell side for a Gunner point. 18-11 now. Hamilton to serve again. Gets the serving instructions from her coach, Coach Gill. A chance here for Sautre, and she puts it down.
Yeah.
Get a replay of that one. Watch a good play there by Gunner. Again, it starts with a good pass, the good set, and then right there in the middle of the court, right in front of the dive from Falgu. So 18-12 now. Gunner back within 6 after trailing by 9.
Oh!
There's Skylar Allen showing you how you do it.
That's the one.
That's the one getting her that scholarship to Division I SEC South Carolina.
Absolutely. That's one it's hard to stay in front of and try to get a block.
I'd be bailing out.
Absolutely.
19-12. Kalispell up by 7. Double hit.
Yep.
These unforced errors not helping Gunner.
Well, and that double hit is so hard to anticipate because every ref seems to call it a little differently.
Some are very strict with it, some not so much.
Yep, so it's hard to know what to expect.
There's a swing by Grillberth that lands out, so another point for Kalispell, and they're rolling here in the second set. After winning the first one 25-20, they're up 21-12, just 4 points away from taking a commanding 2-set-to-none lead. Gunner keeps battling here. There's a ball in the net, dug up there, nice job. I believe that was Childers who got underneath it, was able to keep it alive. Now she's going to set Sautre, and someone hit the antenna. There's the ball. The line judge didn't call it. It was the floor umpire that did.
Yeah, she's the one that made the call. But
the line judge didn't put her flag up. Doesn't matter. It's a point for Kalispell, 22-12. Chance right in the middle that time for Bauckham.
Oh,
Somebody's in the net. Kalisberg was, yep. Might have been Bachman that got a shoulder into the net that time. She was thought about going up for the block.
A good attack. It probably would have been Gunner Point anyway.
Yeah, looked like it. 22-13 after the side out. Bullard going to set up Satterwhite. That's been a pretty good combo here tonight, but a good dig by Gunner. Now Bullard with a quick set over to Allen. Wasn't quite ready for it. And now a point for Kalisberg, side out, double hit. Yeah, like you said, you never know. Those play, I wouldn't have called that one. I didn't see that one.
No, I don't think so.
Very strict by the chair umpire that called that one. 23-13, it's a 10-point lead for Kalisberg. Lindsey Bullard to serve after the captain for Gunner gets the explanation from the chair umpire.
Coach Allen very wisely getting some of her bench in the rotation tonight. Get a little more experience. You never know what's going to happen down in the playoffs.
It's a serve by Bullard. It was a short serve. It's barely saved there.
Ooh,
nice swing that time. There's Beth Gilbert again, and she's able to put it down. Substitution here for Gunner. Checking out will be Shea Pruitt. Checking in to serve will be Audrey Curtis.
Well, you know Gunner's not going to go quietly. They're going to fight to the very end.
Good serve by Curtis. Here's a little back set to Savannah Hunt, and it's in.
It's perfect there.
Just in front of the end line, right here in front of us. So set point for Kalisberg now at 24-14 as Skylar Allen tries to end the second set. That looked like a double to me.
That's out.
But the ball went out on the attack anyway. 25-14, Kalisberg takes the second set. They have a 2-set-to-none lead. We'll step away and take a break. Back with the third set next. You're watching High School Volleyball, ccsportstalk.com.
When your car needs repair, remember ABC. Auto Body Concepts, your complete collision repair facility. At Auto Body Concepts, we take care of you, and we back it up with a lifetime warranty, updating you every step of the way. That's outstanding customer service. Auto Body Concepts, with two big locations in Gainesville, just off Highway 82, and the new location in Ardmore on North Rockford Road. Remember, ABC, Auto Body Concepts, complete collision repair.
The things that bring us together, as families, as friends, as a community, the things that we see, the things that we hear, and the things that we do. The employees of the Cook County Electric Cooperative are proud to be a part of what brings us together. From a cup of coffee to Friday night lights, thank you for letting us be part of your life. Cook County Electrical Cooperative. We'll keep the light on for you.
At Kelly Wimmer Dentistry in Gainesville, we specialize in making beautiful smiles. Dr. Wimmer offers family dentistry for all ages, general dentistry, cosmetic dentistry, restorative care, gum care, and more. Dr. Wimmer strives to help each patient achieve optimal dental care, offering state-of-the-art techniques and equipment. Call for your appointment today, 940-612-4444. That's 940-612-4444. Kelly Wimmer Family and Cosmetic Dentistry, 2022 West Highway 82 in Gainesville, or at WimmerDDS.com.
This is my community.
This is my history.
This is my future.
This is my health.
This is my choice.
This is my hospital.
This is my hospital.
This is my hospital.
This is our hospital.
So glad to have so many of you watching on ccsportstalk.com, especially if you're watching in front of a fireplace tonight.
Absolutely.
Taryn Brazier is.
Yeah.
What is up with that? She has to not only tell us where she's watching from, but send us a picture on Twitter of the fireplace with the full fire, dog in front. Everyone's warm and cozy watching the Lady Cats. So,
Taryn knows how to live. I mean, she's living the life.
Where we are broadcasting from right now, we're right by one of the outside doors, and every time the wind picks up a little bit, I feel a little breeze in here.
It's a little breezy.
I've got my hoodie on, but still.
Looking forward to getting back in the big gym.
Yeah, I bet you are. High school football on Friday night. May be a little chilly, too.
Yeah, and a little wet still.
It's like a high on Friday of 55 degrees. So, of course, middle of October, end of October, that's football weather.
Yeah. How would you like to be a football coach this season, trying to get your practices in, especially if you have a grass field?
Yeah. Talking to Coach Gary Jack on his coach's show on KGF this week, he said they've had to bus over to Woodbine to practice in the gym over there at the elementary school just to find a place to go through a little walkthrough.
Yeah, I'll be sitting down with him tomorrow for our interview for Friday night's game.
I think he and about everybody else that's involved with high school football a little bit tired of all this wet weather.
Yes.
That time, something you don't see very often, the server went over the line when she served, so there's a service error and a point for Kalisburg.
Yeah, you don't see the foot fault very often.
I'm guessing the chair umpire saw that. I didn't see the flag go up from the line judge over there. There's a service error on Skylar Allen.
Skylar Allen gave it back to him, so we'll start even again.
Maybe she felt bad for the girl that got the foot fault call. Here is Satre to serve. Bullard sets up Macy Satterwhite, and she puts it down. Yeah. Well, worth another look here.
Absolutely.
You look at the replay again. The good pass to Bullard. There's that jump set over to Satterwhite on the left side, and not much the libero could do with that one.
Not much at all.
So it will be Fallon Bauckham to serve. Block to the net. Good job. Savannah Hott goes up and blocks that one. Well, I think they actually called it. Never went over the net.
Yeah, it hit the top of the net and went back.
So a couple of quick points here for Kalisburg. Puts them up 3-1. Bauckham to serve again. Right down the line. Good serve. Gunner going to have to scramble to save it. They do. Bullard, the quick set to Sledge. That one hit off the top of the net, but they said it was tipped. Because play continues. Swing by Gilbreth. Here's Satterwhite. I think that one was sailing out, but somebody from Gunner looked like maybe it was Satre went up to try to dig it and went off her fingertips and out.
She just didn't get quite high enough to handle it and let it bounce off her hands and out of bounds.
So another kill for Satterwhite. Puts her team up 4-1 as Fallon Bauckham will serve again. There's a little tip, and Bauckham with a good save. All the way from the back row comes up, and there's the bump out. Go wide that time.
You don't see Bullard do that very often.
So Bauckham will check out. The libero, Chase Falgu, checks back in. Serve goes to Allen. There's Savannah Hott. Off the nice set from Bullard. 5-2, Kalisburg's lead back to 3, as it will be Savannah Hott to serve right in front of our floor camera here. Ooh. And it goes into the net. Service error makes it 5-3. And it will be J.C. Childers to serve for the Lady Tigers. That one barely cleared the net. Good save there by Allen, but Kalisburg not able to get it back over.
A little miscommunication on the back line there between Enderby and Falgu.
You got it. I got it.
Yep.
None of us got it.
And nobody got it.
5-4 now. Childers to serve again for the Lady Tigers. Who brought a good crowd tonight? Big crowd for Kalisburg. Again, we're in the old gym, so there's only bleachers on one side, so you're not seeing the fans. There's a nice hit by Satterwhite for Kalisburg.
Well, Kalisburg has learned to love their volleyball over the last few years. Well, for longer than that, they've been very good supporters of volleyball.
Yeah, it's been a winning program, not just the past 4 years. It's been obviously at a much higher level than before, but they've been a perennial playoff team. Yeah. There's a big swing by Skylar Allen and puts it down.
Well, Coach Allen's been here about 15 years, and we've had winning programs before that, but her 15 years have been extremely successful.
Yeah, I saw her husband, Mark Allen, who's up there in the stands watching, along with former Major League pitcher Sam Freeman, who's here watching.
Sam
tonight.
Freeman's in the house. Janelle Dryling's son-in-law.
Yeah. There's another point for Gunner as Kalisburg couldn't get it over the net that time. 7-5 now. They get the serve for Beth Gilbreth. Goes back behind the service line. Ooh. Oh, there's an ace there just by default. Kalisberg thought it was going to go out, and it didn't.
Just misjudged it a little bit, and it fell about 3 inches inside the back line.
I thought it was going out too, but it lands in.
It did die right as it got toward the back line.
A little top spin on it, I guess. 7-6 now. Gunners back within one. They trail this match 2-0. Here's Skylar Allen down the line.
Yeah.
Good save by Gunner, but they can't get it back over. That's one of those dives you just stick your palm out there and hope it hits. So 8-6 now is Chase Falgu to serve. Attack here, Olivia F. just tips it over. Skylar Allen goes up to try to hit it. And now somebody's in the net, they're going to get Gunner in the net. 9-6, the Kalisberg lead up to 3.
Wow.
What a serve by Falgur.
I think she got helped out a little bit on that one. It looked like it might have been headed toward out of bounds, and the Gunner player decided to play it.
She'll take it.
Absolutely.
Makes it 10-6. There's a back set, and they're going to call a double.
Double hit, yeah.
Yep. Got Lindsay Buller that time.
I can kind of see that one had a little bit of change and spin on the ball.
So side out, the serve. Here's Nia Ingram for Gunner.
Oh, that's out.
Yep, Skylar Allen went down the line but hit it out. Point Gunner, they're back within 2 now at 10-8. Ingram slaps the ball a couple of times before she serves. Here's Bullard. Somehow, Skylar out. Well, she got it inside the antenna, but she couldn't stay out of the net.
Yeah, she did a great job reaching back for the ball and getting it over, but by that time she was out of position and wound up raising the net.
Yeah, her whole body was on the left side of the antenna. There's another ace. Again, it lands just on the line, and we're tied at 10. Good serving here by Nia Ingram to rally her team back and tie things up here in the third set. Kalisberg going to try to get a sight out here. They go back to Macy Satterwhite. Nice dig on the back row by J.C. Childers. Buller this time going to set up Allen, who just has to tip it over. So a chance here for Gunner. Another tip of the net. Dug by Enderby. Here's Skylar Allen. Stays on her side of the net. She's frustrated. And just like that, Gunner has their first lead.
Well, one of the things that's important to remember, I think, is that these teams like Gunner, they have no pressure. The worst thing that can happen is get beat again. You know, it's not going to affect their rankings. So Kalisberg's the one that's got the pressure on.
Yeah, it doesn't help when the announcer comes on and starts the broadcast by saying they have a 35-match District 1 winning streak either. No,
well, sometimes that jinxes them.
Yeah. We got some big district winning streaks in several sports. We'll talk about that here in a moment. 12-10. Skylar Allen says, I'll take care of that, side out.
Well, and one of the issues for the Lady Cats is down the stretch is going to be the issue of pressure because, you know, like as you said earlier, this is the year to do it if you're going to do it because these great seniors. So they're going to have to learn to deal with that pressure and perform even when the pressure's there.
Lindsay Bullard serving here for Kalisberg. And it results in a point. Yeah, talking about district winning streaks, of course, Lindsay, if they win tonight, we'll be at 101 straight district wins. But that's not, and then of course 35 here for Kalisberg. But Munster basketball, boys basketball has 56 straight district wins. Munster baseball, something in the 30s. Munster football, of course, hasn't lost in 5 years in district. So our local teams in Cook County doing some good things.
Well, you mentioned Lindsay volleyball. You know, Coach Anderle was a coach here at Kalisberg for several years. Well, she headed over that way.
But yeah, she's been successful now in two different programs.
Absolutely.
Kalisberg's rallied back to take a 13-12 lead. Now 13-13 as that little tip over the net finds an open spot right in the middle of the Kalisberg defense. Just good all-around volleyball in Cook County between Kalisberg, Lindsay, Valley View, Sacred Hearts added to volleyball, Gainesville, of course, trying to get things turned around. There's a service there. So point for Kalisberg. We could very well see two county teams at the state tournament this year if both take care of business.
Would not be surprised.
There's a good play by Fallon Bachram to go up and just tip that one over. The ball came across the net.
Good direction on the tip, putting down where the floor was vacant.
So it's 15-13, Lady Cats lead as Skylar Allen serves. Coming into your screen right about there. Nice save on the back row by Falgu. Here's Macy Satterwhite down the line. Nice dig by Gunner. He'll tip again. Skylar Allen
nice.
Somehow lays out to keep that one alive. Good rally here by the two teams. Again, the libero Falgu with the dig. Satterwhite cross court and in.
Nice.
Man, it all started, Ronnie, with the full extension dive by Skylar Allen to keep that ball alive.
Absolutely. She gave up her body to get that one and keep it in play.
Timeout called. Kalispell leading 16-13. You're watching High School Volleyball, ccsportstalk.com. Back in a moment.
If you're looking for a seriously simple mortgage, look no further than First State Bank. Our lending specialists take great pride in helping homebuyers get the best mortgage. We give you options that suit your needs and keep the lending process as simple as possible. Build your relationship with a First State Bank lender now by calling 940-665-1711 or applying online at f-s-b.com.
Back to action, Kalispell leading 16-13 here in the third set. Nice play at the net that time by Childers, but Kalispell saved it, but it goes off the block of Bachram out, so a side out for Gunner.
That's one of those plays when you're doing radio, it's hard to describe as it happens. Just that bang, bang, bang. You have to take a time out and describe the play again.
Yeah, you have to paint the picture and call everything. Luckily here on our video broadcast, the viewer can see most of it. We just try to fill in the holes. There's a little tip over the net attempt that time by Childers, but it doesn't go over the net, so a side out Kalispell. 17-14. With Fallon Bachram to serve. There's a block of the net. Savannah Hott got up there to block it, but it went out. You got to turn your hands a certain way to get that block to be able to stay in bounds. And that one just went off of her palms and landed a couple of feet out.
Well, it didn't help that it was hit very hard.
It was hit hard. Gunner can hit the ball hard, I can
tell you.
They got several hitters.
Well, they've had a winning program themselves for a long time down at Gunner. Ooh.
There's a nice serve, results in a point. Yeah, you remember going back to when they had Michaela Watson.
Right.
Tanya Watson, the coach there.
Right.
They went several rounds deep in the playoffs. Of course, she went on to play at Oklahoma Baptist. I think she's still up there, along with Lindsay's Nicole Flyman, their teammates.
I believe so, yeah. And, of course, Tanya was the head coach down there, and she stepped down so she could have a chance to go watch her daughter play at the college level.
18-16 after that service error. Savannah Hott with the serve this time. Nice save by Gunner. Lindsay Bullard tried to put it in the back corner. That little tip, nice diving save by Hott. Here's Satterwhite. Gunner almost kept it alive, but the ball hits the floor for a point for Kalispell.
It's one of those cases where the kill wasn't very impressive, but you got the point anyway.
Madison Wirtz going to check in here for Emma Sledge. Another senior getting some action here in the third set.
That's one thing about Savannah Hott being out for several weeks is some of the girls came off the bench and played very well, got some good experience.
There's a block of the net. That time, Wirtz and Bullard going up. Bullard, Allen, Satterwhite, puts it down. How many times in your radio broadcast in the last 4 years have you mentioned those three names all in the same play? Allen, Bullard, Satterwhite.
Exactly, yeah.
What a trio.
You want those girls on the floor all the time.
Can they get a fifth year of eligibility? Can come back as super
great,
seniors, right? Along with the other seniors on that senior class. There's one there. Madison Wirtz. She just checks in and she gets a kill.
Gotten more play time because Hot was out there for so long, and she's been swinging at the ball very well.
21-16, Kalisburg 4 points away from the victory tonight. It's a nice serve by Hot.
Oh,
nice swing by Gilbert. Gives Gunner a side out and a point. And again, they're not going quietly as Jill Enderby checks in. Savannah Hot checks out. And J.C. Childers to serve for the Lady Tigers. Bullard sets up center wide. He just tries to tip it over. Nice diving attempt there by Ingram, but it hits off her palm, lands on the Gunner side. Point Kalisburg.
Yeah, that one might have gone out of bounds, but you can't afford to let it go. You got to go for it.
She didn't want to take the chance. 22-17 now. Good serve there by Satterwhite. Here's Falgu. Bullard back set behind the 10-foot line. Macy Satterwhite, good dig, though, by Gunner. Here's a free ball and chance for Kalisburg. Bullard sets up Wirtz. Gunner's in the net. Point Kalisburg, 23-17. Two points away from victory. They already lead 2-0. There's a service error. Now, in volleyball, do you get to call it 2-0 like you do in tennis? Is there any love in volleyball?
I don't think there's a lot of love in volleyball.
Yeah, it doesn't look like it as hard as they hit the ball. We'll go with 2-0, the set count here. 23-18 after the side out. Beth Gilbert, another serve. Here's Falgo, just going to have to bump it over. So a chance for the Lady Tigers. Big swing by Sautre, blocked by Bullard and Wirtz. Here's Allen. Nobody blocking her.
No, not that time.
24-18, it's match point.
They tried to take the inside angle away from her, so she just went back and went straight down the line.
Chase Falgu, the senior, going to try to serve this match over. And there's a hit out, and we are done.
That will do it.
25-20, 25-14, 25-10. Kalisburg wins in three. Their district winning streak continues. And they make their, I'm not sure, have they clinched the district championship already?
I would say so at this point. They have not lost any, and everybody else has at least two losses. So one more match on Tuesday night. But they've got it locked up at this point.
Well, we appreciate everybody joining us tonight on our broadcast here from Kalisburg High School. Again, the Lady Cats win 25-20, 25-14, 25-10. Don't forget Cook County Sports Talk tomorrow night, 5:30 to 7 on Hometown Radio KGAF. We've got the members of the North Central Texas College volleyball team will be joining us in studio. Also, cross-country runners from Munster High School that are heading on to regionals will be stopping by. And we've got a special guest to tell us about a big trail run coming up here north of Kalisburg. As if you want to run 26 miles in the woods and up and down hills, he'll tell you all about it tomorrow night. Cook County Sports Talk, 5:30 to 7 on Hometown Radio KGAF.
If I might interject, Tuesday night will be the final home game of the season for the Lady Cats, senior night. Going to be a big night because we've got so many great seniors on this team. So playing Whitesboro, a little bit of rivalry there.
And I think, actually, that's the next broadcast we're going to have from here on Tuesday night. So we'll be here for senior night.
Great.
Yeah, looking forward to that.
Absolutely.
Again, Kalisburg wins 3-0. Thanks so much for watching. Cook County Sports Talk TV from ccsportstalk.com.